The Anti-Terrorism Council has designated the National Democratic Front as a terrorist organization. In a resolution signed last June 23, the council called the NDF an integral and inseparable part, of the Communist Party of the Philippines and the New People's Army. It also noted CPP founder Jose Maria Sison identified the CPP-NPA as allied organizations of the NDF. The CPP-NPA was designated as a terrorist organization last year. A court in Olongapo City junks the first known anti-terrorism case in the Philippines. The two ETAs were arrested in August 2020 for allegedly firing at military members, killing one soldier. But the court said the prosecution failed to prove the identities of the accused as the perpetrators. It also noted inconsistencies in the statements of witnesses. Over 20 governors from different political parties backing calls for President Duterte to run for vice president next year. Among them are Bulacan Governor Daniel Fernando, Nueva Ecija Governor Aurelio Umali, Quirino Governor Dakila Cua, Bohol Governor Arthur Yap, and Eastern Samar Governor Ben Evardone. They believe Duterte as vice president will continue to benefit the Philippines. President Duterte again hinted he will run for VP during the ruling PDP-Laban Party's General Assembly this past weekend. Meanwhile, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio defends her recent trips around the Philippines as the pandemic rages. The president's daughter says a decision has to be made about her political career with or without the health crisis. Duterte Carpio, a rumored presidential candidate in the 2022 elections, recently traveled to meet former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo in Pasay City, Governor Gwen Garcia in Cebu, and Zamboanga City Mayor Ben Climaco. But she says her trips were covered by duly filed absences that she's not neglecting her duties as Davao City Mayor. Vice President Lenny Robredo welcomes the call of several senators to investigate alleged state-sponsored troll farms. During her weekly radio show, Robredo stressed the need for a probe, citing the serious life and death consequences of online misinformation. 12 senators earlier filed a resolution seeking to investigate reports public funds are being used to set up troll farms all over the country ahead of next year's polls.
Ano ba yung epekto ng pagkakaroon ng mga troll sa atin? Pinapag-away-away yung mga tao. Di ba ka, Eli, ever since naman may mga oposisyon, may administrasyon, pero hindi ganito kagrabe yung away. Mula 2016, magkontra ka sa administrasyon, isa-swarm ka. Isa-swarm ka ng mga trolls. Na ito, yung karapatan mo na pumuna ay... nawawala kasi natatakot yung ibang tao.